नमस्कार। स्वेटिंग इज अ नेचुरल फिनोमिनन। इट रियली हेल्प्स टू रेगुलेट योर बॉडी टेम्परेचर। इन हॉट क्लाइमेट व्हेन पर्सन स्वेट्स दैट हेल्प्स टू रेगुलेट दैट हीट व्हिच इज देयर इन द एक्सटर्नल वर्ल्ड। बट स्वेटिंग बिकम्स अ बिग प्रॉब्लम फॉर दोज हु स्वेट प्रोफ्यूजली इन स्पाइट ऑफ कोल्ड क्लाइमेट एंड दिस इज डेफिनेटली अ प्रॉब्लम। देयर आर सम पीपल who sweat only on their palm as well as on their feet. They sweat so much that hands are always wet and legs, when they are walking on a clean floor, you can see footprints there, a water over there. And then they say that this is our problem and we don't know what to do about it. It is a problem. And yoga says that this is a problem of a proper circulation. In our body, when a proper circulation is not there, anything excess in one or other area is bound to happen. And so, now let us understand how to go about with this problem. Apart from proper circulation, there are many other causes. And they could be genetics, it could be heart problem, it could be diabetes, it could be menopause, it could be hot flushes, and it could be even overactive thyroid. So, let's see some ways in which you could handle this condition. First, apply chandan and rose water. Mix chandan and rose water to make a paste. Apply this paste on your palm, hands and sole of your feet. Leave it for 15-20 minutes and then dip your hands and legs in cold water for 15-20 minutes again. Since time immemorial, chandan is used for reducing the sweat and rose water has cooling effect. This combination can minimize oversweating of palm and feet. Second, cold concentrated black tea. Dip a cloth in that cold and concentrated black tea and wipe your palm and feet with that cloth. The tannic acid in tea has astringent property that can act as a natural antiperspirant, or you could even soak your palm and feet in the same liquid. I would suggest that you could make an ice of this liquid and rub that ice on your legs and feet. That would be beautiful. You can even carry black tea bag and soak it in the water and hold it in your palm, and that itself would help you to reduce sweat. Third point, application of ice. You can rub your palm and feet with the ice cube in the morning. This would close the pore and minimize your sweating. You can rub this ice cube for a minute and then wipe it out with a dry cloth. Fourth point, apply talcum powder. Dust pure non-perfumed talcum powder on your palm as well as on your feet. Talcum powder will definitely help your palm and feet remain dry. Powder has a cooling and even has anti-perspiring property. It absorbs the moisture and keeps your skin dry for a long time. Fifth point, certain foods to avoid. Avoid heat producing food and food that causes oversweating. Avoid garlic, onion, spicy food, non-vegetarian food and even oily food. These foods tend to increase sweating, and so try and avoid them as far as possible. Sixth point, yoga techniques. Do asanas to increase blood circulation in your extremities. Asanas which are there to stretch your extremities should be done regularly. And these asanas are as follows. One is Talasan, Yastikasan, Pavadamuktasan, Supta Vakrasan, and Hastapad Angushtasan 1 and 2. Certain pranayams like pranayam number 4, diaphragmic breathing, and Shitali Shitkari. These pranayams will definitely help cooling down your system and control over sweating. You can get rid of over sweaty palms and feet by following these home remedies. But above all, most important is what? Keeping your mind calm and composed. When mind is disturbed, sweat is going to come out. When you are going to get angry or agitated, or when you worry, or when you are under fear, you will definitely sweat excessively. When the mind is in your control, when a mind is positive and calm, then it is going to avoid all kinds of health disorders. So try and see that overall, following these home remedies are wonderful, but taking care of your positivity of mind, enthusiasm of your mind, happiness in your mind, and that works wonders. Namaskar.